Hey everybody, this is Ian O'Byrne again. We're taking a look at the week of November 18th, or ending in November 18th, 2017. We're going to take a look at Too Long Didn't Read, issue number 124, as a way to sort of take a look at my week and some of the events of the week, and then also what happened in teaching, learning, and tech to try and make sense of all these changes that always occur. A couple big things came out this week. I had a couple posts that came out. I also extended my look at showing as opposed to telling and my use of recorded and animated GIFs or GIFs. Definitely recommend checking that out. Something that I've been trying to figure out, not only as I write and share online, but how can I use screen capture, screencasts, but then the animated GIFs to try and show or express information. I talked about this in the past, but I've been working on a piece for a book coming out called The Digitally Agile Researcher. This is something I was asked to do a little over a year ago, I believe. And so it's good to see that the book is finally coming out. Really interested to, arrange times to set up interviews over the coming weeks or months with people in the text, because I think we present a lot of interesting points. And I like to get people on video to talk about their pieces in the book. I had the video that came along with it. I was pretty excited to see that Natalia and Oliver reached out to the publishers to get a nice little video. They had a shorter video, which was, I think, a little under 30 seconds that came along. Was put out on YouTube as a way to market the book. And then also this longer video. So definitely excited to see that they're thinking a little bit more broadly about text. The first story that I started with was we've seen more information come out about the shadow brokers hack of the NSA and some of the materials that they released. There's a lot of anecdotal stories about how this is a lot worse than the Snowden leaks. We've seen some of the hacks come out and the tools that they stole be used against others. I basically counter that with a talk I went to this past week with Marina, who is the head or chair of the Global Commission on the Stability of Cyberspace. Really interesting talk, really interesting person thinking about cybersecurity, privacy, security. She urged me to get in touch with some black hat hackers to see, okay, well, what does this mean for teaching and learning? What's this mean for our classroom? So it was interesting thinking about those two pieces as counters during this week. Great piece by Kathy O'Neill, which if you have not read her book, Weapons of Math Destruction, it's excellent. I've been gifting it to friends and family and colleagues as we head out for conferences this year. And she has a piece about the ivory tower and, how academics and academe generally ignores tech. Or for the most part, we see tech as like this cottage industry where some people get it and use it and others don't. So really great piece as always by Kathy. And I was also at the same time finishing up and gifting her book. So it was good to see her, her show up in those different places. At the same time, there's a very interesting reading list on algorithms and AI and making sense of this from a critical perspective that came around my feeds. And I made sure to bookmark it and share it out. So if you're interested in reading more about, thinking as algorithm or learning algorithmically, definitely a great series of reads in here, pretty comprehensive series of reads to make sense of it. For the most part, a whole entire program that you could dig into. A great piece by Kathy Davidson talking about critical digital or critical pedagogies. And how we can embed more of these activist or advocacy in our classes. Oh, there we go. And so great piece thinking about, and this is Kathy was pulling in, I think, two different posts from the past and sort of revising it with the help of some grad students to really make a one-stop shop for ways that you can embed critical pedagogies in instruction. Definitely worth a read. And as I say here, if you're teaching in, you know, pre-K up through higher ed, something to take a look at and sort of calibrate your teaching and learning practice and think about how, you know, critically literate or how much critical focus you employ into your classes. Moving along, we have a great piece by Jennifer Gonzalez on the Cult of Pedagogy website, talking about teaching students how to legally use images online. I have a lot of different posts like this digging into Creative Commons on my website. And Kathy does a good job. Jennifer does a really good job of pulling all of this together into one post. A pretty long post, but you know, it pretty much is soup to nuts, everything that you need to know about, you know, using these images. And once again, I love the Cult of Pedagogy website and the look and feel of all the materials there. Wrapping up the reading section of this, there is a piece in here about, you know, Aaron put in a piece about his use of Google Apps and Google Suite and the different tools. I really valued this because it was very concise and it was just a general overview of the different texts and tools and ways that you can use Google Apps in your classroom and in your practice. For me, it was a very, it was good to see sort of like a, just almost like directives of here's things that you can do with tech and with these tools in your classroom. So I really enjoyed that and I've been sending it out to my students as a wrap up materials for the semester. In the make section, I talked a little bit about testing out grayscale. Here in TLDR, we've been talking for a while about how, you know, we are addicted to our phones and our apps and the notifications. We've also talked a little bit about how the bright colors are made to sort of attract your eyes and keep your eyes glued to the screen and give you that hit every time you look at it. And so you desire it more. And so you're addicted to these spaces. And so one of the things I've been doing is I turn my phone over to grayscale to see what impact that would have on my usage of these devices. Anecdotally from the beginning, like I feel like I use it a little bit less, but I'm always on these screens. It's been interesting going on to look at materials. You know, you're either shopping on your phone or you're looking at a website or you're trying to quickly find an app and it's hard to figure out colors because everything's grayscale. And so you're looking at something and you're like, oh, this looks really interesting. And then you go over to the website on the laptop and you realize, oh, it's not at all what I thought it would be because I don't have the colors as part of it. At the same time, it's been fun. If I hand, you know, I hand the phone over to my son and he looks at something on my phone and he's like, you know, we'll take a picture out at the park or I'll take a picture of them playing and I'll show the photo to the kids. And they're like, what's wrong with your phone? I'm like, it's grayscale. I'm trying something out. And they just don't get it. Pulling it all together, I've been reading a lot from Tim Ferriss and his Tools of Titans book. And one of the things that he talks about is sort of red teaming. And red teaming is a process where as you prepare materials, you basically think about all alternatives or, you know, ways to attack your idea or your project. And so a red team is trying to find all of the loose ends and make sure you address it before, you know, you're sort of surprised in a review. And so this is a good quote by Robert Gates, thinking about how to really red team and think in a totally opposite way than you normally would. And so once again, this is taking a look at issue 124 of Too Long Didn't Read. A lot of different moving parts this week as we sort of head out of November. You know, hopefully this was of value to you. If you haven't seen a lot of my other posts online, you can head on over to wioburn.com. That has all of my blog posts. I'm embedding my videos in there as well. A lot of different elements and trying to do a better job of folding in my newsletter to the website so that people can go in quickly and read it and highlight and annotate and use Hypothesis. But if you have not subscribed already, you can head on over to wiobarn.com/TLDR and head on down to subscribe there. So hopefully this works for you. By all means, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Give a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you're feeling the need to this video. And have a great rest of the week.